प्रेजेंटेशन के लिए रेडी हो जाओ, लास्ट वन। चलिए शुरू करिए। तो प्रेजेंटेशन किसका है? स्टार्ट। हाँ
गुड इवनिंग। स्क्विड स्टैंड्स फॉर सुपर क्वांटम इंटरफेरेंस डिवाइसेस, नॉट दिस। गुड इवनिंग रिस्पेक्टेड एचओडी सर एंड एवरीवन। आई एम मोहम्मद अफसार आलम एंड माय टीम मेंबर्स आर एस फॉलोज। खुशी सिंह, ख्याति चंद्राकर, मानव त्रिपाठी, मोहम्मद अफसार आलम, मोहम्मद जैद एंड मोहम्मद अयान। नाउ मूविंग ऑन टू द नेक्स्ट स्लाइड, आई विल लेट खुशी टू गिव मोर इंट्रोडक्शन ऑन द टॉपिक।
Thank you, sir. Good evening, all. Myself, Khushi Singh, and I am going to explain the topic squid and Josephson junction. A squid is a very sensitive magnetometer used to measure extremely subtle magnetic fields. Based on superconducting loops containing Josephson junction, squids are so sensitive enough to measure field as low as 5×10⁻¹⁸ Tesla. The superconducting quantum interference device, SQUID, consists of two superconductors separated by thin insulating layers to form two parallel Josephson junctions. The device may be configured as a magnetometer to detect incredibly small magnetic fields, small enough to measure the magnetic fields in living organism. Now coming to next slide, please. Now, coming to Josephson junction, superconducting tunnel junction. The Josephson junction is the phenomenon of supercurrent, a current that flows continuously without any voltage applied across a device known as Josephson junction, which consists of two or more superconductors coupled by a weak link. They are either by created by an insulator or a non-superconducting conductor or a constriction in the superconducting material that weakens the superconductivity at a point of contact. The evolution of the Josephson phase is phi equal to phi b minus phi a, and the time derivative of the charge carrier density is n, is proportional to the current I. The above solution yields the Josephson equation, that is first Josephson relation or weak link current phase relation, that is IT equal to IC sin omega t, where IC stands for the critical current. Critical current is maximum current that junction can sustain. And phi b minus phi a is the phase difference of electron wave function of two superconductors. And the second Josephson relation or superconducting phase evolution equation is del phi by del t equal to 2EVT upon H cross. Now, I will invite Apsar Alam to give more information about this topic. Over to you, Apsar.
Thank you, Khushi. There are three main effects predicted by Josephson that follow directly from the Josephson equation: DC Josephson equation, AC Josephson equation, inverse AC Josephson equation. First, DC Josephson effect. The DC Josephson effect is a direct current crossing the insulator in the absence of any external electromagnetic field owing the tunneling. AC Josephson effect. With the fixed voltage VDC across the junction, the phase will vary linearly with the time, and the current will be AC, alternative current with the amplitude IC and frequency KIVDC. Inverse AC Josephson effect. Microwave radiation of a single angular frequency omega can induce quantized DC voltages across the Josephson junction, in which case the Josephson phase takes the form. And the voltage of the current across the junction will be. The DC components are. There are two main types of squid. The direct current DC and the radio frequency RF. RF squids can work with only one junction, the superconducting tunnel junction, which might make them cheaper to produce but are less sensitive. DC squid. It has two Josephson junction in a parallel in a superconducting loop. It is based on the DC Josephson effect. RF squid. It is based on the AC Josephson effect and uses only one Josephson junction. Is less sensitive compared to DC squid, but is cheaper and easier to manufacture in smaller quantities. DC squid. In the absence of any external magnetic field, the input current I splits into two branches equally. As soon as the current is in either branch exceeds the critical current IC of the Josephson junction, a voltage appears across the junction. RF squid. The RF squid is inductively coupled to a resonant tank circuit. Depending on the external magnetic field as the squid operates in the resistive mode, the effective induced in inductance of the tank circuit changes, thus changing the resonant frequency of the tank circuit. Now I would like to give Manav to take over the presentation.
Thank you, Apsar. So here are the applications of squids. Magnetoencephalography, for example, uses of measurement of an array of squids to make inference about neural activity inside brains. Another area where squids are used in magnetogastrography, which is concerned with recording the weak magnetic fields of the stomach. A novel application of squids is the magnetic marker monitoring method, which is used to trace the path of orally applied drugs. In the clinical environment, squids are used in cardiology for magnetic field imaging, which detects the magnetic field of the heart for diagnosis and risk stratification. The most common commercial use of squids is in magnetic property measurement system. Next slide, please. Squids are being used as detectors to perform magnetic resonance imaging, while high field MRI uses precision field of 1 to several teslas. Squids detected MRI use measurement field that lie in the microtesla range. Squids detected MRI has advantage over high field MRI systems, such as the low cost required to build such a system and its compactness. The use of squids in oil prospecting, mineral exploration, earthquake predictions, and geometrical energy surveying is becoming more widespread as superconductors. A modified RF squid was used to observe the dynamic Gesmer effect for the first time. Squids are used in supermagnetic relaxometry, a technology that utilizes the high magnetic field sensitivity of squid sensors and the super paramagnetic properties of magnetite nanoparticles. Next slide, please.
So these are our sources from which we have extracted our content, and I like to thank sir to give us this opportunity. The data provided by RPG चंद्राकर, अयान खान, खुशी सिंह, मोहम्मद जैद. प्रेजेंटेशन मेड बाय ख्याति चंद्राकर, प्रेजेंटेड बाय मी अफसार आलम, खुशी सिंह, मानव त्रिपाठी. थैंक यू वन एंड ऑल.
ओके, सो इट वाज अ गुड प्रेजेंटेशन. सबने बहुत बेहतरीन मेहनत किया. टू बी फ्रेंकली, मैंने इतना एक्सपेक्ट नहीं किया था कि तुम लोग इतने बेहतरीन प्रेजेंटेशन बना पाओगे और प्रेजेंट कर पाओगे, और मेरे एक्सपेक्टेशन के से बियॉन्ड बहुत अच्छे से तुम लोगों ने किया है. एक डिस्कशन सेशन में रखूंगा अलग से तुम सबका सुनने के बाद, ठीक है? एक्चुअली अभी आज थोड़ा सा मैं मीटिंग अटेंड किया हूँ, ऐसे भी थक गया हूँ. तो इसको मैं कल, ये जो 5 लेक्चर आज हमने रिकॉर्ड किया है, ये सारे लेक्चर्स को कल मैं यूट्यूब चैनल पर डालूंगा. हाँ, एक बार तुम लोग और